Hey guys, what's up? Welcome to another video, and today we're gonna continue our beginner's guide for Octane materials. And today we're gonna take a look and we're gonna learn how to use the scattering medium, and we are gonna create this very beautiful candle over here. Okay, so I'm very excited to get started, so let's do it. Okay guys, so let's start from the beginning, right? So the first thing I'm gonna do is delete the shaders on these candles. So to do that, go to the material properties and delete it. And now let's create another material, new material. And the first thing we are gonna do here is put the transmission to white and the albedo to black. And the second thing we're gonna do is actually add a scattering medium. So shift A, S to search, and scattering medium, this one here, and plug it on here on the median. Okay guys, so one very important thing here about the subsurface scattering. To make it work, actually you have to turn on fake shadows, okay? So that's very important. Okay, so once you make it, the next step is to put a color on the absorption. So let's put something like an yellow close to the color of like a normal candle, right? Now I'm using this absorption color, but usually I create an sRGB. Oops. Not, I think it's RG. Yeah, it's RGB spectral text. This one here. And I use this guy instead of the color on the scattering and the absorption. Okay, so I don't know why, but I think there is anything related to it, but I think it works a little bit better, but maybe I'm completely wrong about it and it doesn't make probably any difference, but I like to use it. Okay, so you don't need to use it, but if you want to, just like create this RGB spectrum text. Okay, so now let's put the color here. So let's use something like yellowish. And what these two parameters over here, the scattering, actually the absorption texture and the scattering texture, what they do, one controls how much light the surface will absorb, and the other one, that is the scattering texture, it determines how fast light can move through the surface. Okay, so that's very important to keep in mind. Here you're gonna see if I change the color like to black on this scattering parameter here, you're gonna see that the light won't pass through the surface. So different when I change it to white, you're gonna see that we have this very nice subsurface scattering working very well here. So we have the light scattering around all the surface. Okay, so it's important to keep it in mind, because sometimes you don't want like too much light passing through the surface, so you can control it over here. Okay, and to create the candle effect where the light is stronger on the top and a little weak on the bottom, we have to increase the density. So let's put something like 300, yeah, something like this, maybe a little bit more. It's you the pen now. It's like just a taste, and you can always like take a look on reference, of course. Yeah, 300, 350. I think it's a good number, not bad. So let's increase a little bit more here the scattering. Let's take a look the result. To render it fast, I'm gonna make a region here, a crop. Let me see the color here. Let's increase a little bit more. Yeah, like this. Very nice effect. Okay, so let's add the final touch here. That is a bump map. So let's, I'm gonna add this bump here from the 3D collective. Let me show you this one here. Add it to the bump map here, bump slot, and actually I have to apply a full transform. This texture is, I think it's too big for this geometry, so I'm gonna decrease it to something like 0.5. and yeah, so let's make a entire render here, and I wait for the final render, and I'm gonna show you after it finish. Okay, so see you very soon. Okay, I think almost finished, but maybe the bump here is like, I don't know, maybe a little big, but I will make another one. I will adjust like the size of this bump here. Maybe I have to invert it, just maybe, and I'll make another render, maybe with a small value here, probably 0.2, and I'll show you after it finished. Probably I'll render it pressing F12. I think it's the best solution here. Okay, so that's it, guys. I hope you have enjoyed, and if you like it, please subscribe to my channel and let me know also your thoughts about my videos. I'm very excited to answer any questions you may have, or I don't know, anything that you want maybe to comment. Please comment anything and I'll be glad to answer, okay? So thank you very much, guys, and see you in the next video.